We are discussing chapter number 5, that is continuity and differentiability. So what we have seen in earlier discussions, that what is the differentiation and how we differentiate the functions. We learned about differentiation of polynomial functions, the trigonometric functions. Here we'll talk about the continuity, the differentiability, and what is the relationship between these two. We'll also touch upon the inverse trigonometric functions, and then we'll see the exponential and logarithmic function. Then we'll see how powerful these exponential and logarithmic functions can be when it corresponds to differentiation. Then we'll also see some part of differential calculus, means actually we'll see the conditions. We'll be discussing this in the later chapters, and we'll see the fundamental theorems as well. Continuity. So what is continuity? See, before I go ahead and teach you, tell you about all these mathematics, there is one simple thing which you need to understand. If you understand this thing, whatever I am speaking after this will be well understood. Even if you don't understand in the later part, but what I am saying, just remember that. I have a pen. I am making that function graph. If I am making that function for that particular domain, means say from 7 to 20, I'm just taking any number. I'm making a function graph, and I don't have to pick up the pen, or I don't have to take off the pen. I can make a smooth graph, or it may be smooth like this, smooth line. I don't have to pick my pen to draw it again. Means if I have to check, or I have to pick my pen, then it is not continuous. If I don't have to pick, I can make in this domain, then we say that the function is continuous. Okay, I hope you got the idea how continuity works. Now let us take some informal examples like this. We have function fx, which is 1 if x is less than or equal to 0. So this is a function which is 1 if x is less than or equal to 0. All these x, fx is nothing but y. You have to put the value of x, that is you have to put 0 or less than values so that you get y. So what will be the y? Y will be 1. Y is 1. Y is 1 when fx is 1. Y is 1 when fx is less than or equal to 0. Similarly, y, that is fx is 2 if x is greater than 0. So I put 0 here, or not 0 but greater than 0 values, I find this line. See, the function is like this. So what about the nearby areas when it is close to x-axis for these two? If you take some point here, say here, just here, it will be minus 0.1, minus 0.01, or minus 0.001. If you take any point of this, it approaches 1. If you take a point here, this point, then it will be 0.1, 0.001, like this. And as we see here, that the function is 1 on the left hand side, or it approaches the left hand limit. The left hand limit of f is at 0 is 1, but the right hand is 2. See, here it is 1. Left hand limit, this is left hand, this is right hand. Left hand limit is 1, but the right hand limit is 2. So the left hand limit and right hand limit, they do not coincide. They are not equal. And as I just said, if I have to make this function, I have to lift my pen. I have to pick my pen. I cannot draw this function without picking up my phone pen. This cannot be drawn in one stroke. These functions are called not continuous. They are not continuous. Okay. Now let us consider one more function. Fx is equal to 1 if x is not equal to 0, and fx is equal to 2 if x is equal to 1, is equal to 0. So this is y equal to fx. This is y is equal to fx. Now if I put any value which is not 0, it will give you 1. If I put value 0, it will give me 2. What will be the graph? See, if I take the left hand limit, if I take the right hand limit at this point 0, at the x equal to 0, the left hand limit and right hand limit, they coincide. Or you can say the value at 0 coincide for this function. This function is called the continuous function at 0. This function is continuous at 0. That means I don't have to lift my pen if I want to draw this function. If I have to lift my pen, it is not continuous. If I don't have to lift my pen, I can draw this in one go, one stroke, then this function is continuous. See, if I don't have to, this is very important. That is why I'm pressurizing it, emphasizing it. If I draw it without lifting pen, it is continuous. If I draw, or if I can't draw without lifting, it is not continuous. This you have to understand. Mathematically, let us see the definition. Let us say of f is a real function on subset of real numbers, and let C be a point on that domain. That domain, that is, see, if you have a graph, you have a point here. So f is continuous at C if you apply the limit, that is the left hand limit and right hand limit, it is equal to fc. If you place this value, it should be equal to the limit. So left hand limit, right hand limit, and the value of the function at x equal to c must exist, and they should be equal. Then we say that f is continuous at x equal to c, right? I hope you got the idea. So let us rephrase the definition of continuity now. Again, a function is continuous at some point x equal to c if the function is defined at x equal to c. First of all, if the value of the function at x equal to c, that is the point we have seen at 0, etc., is equal to the limit of the function at x equal to c. If f is not continuous at c, f is discontinuous at c, and c is the point which is called as the point of discontinuity of f. Let us check the continuity of this function to fx equal to 2x plus 3 at x equal to 1. So you just have to do certain things. This function is defined at x equal to 1. You see, 2 into 1 plus 3, it is defined. Means if I would have placed 2x plus 3 by x, so this is not defined at x equal to 0, because we cannot have 0 in the denominator, but x equal to 1, it is defined. The value is 5. So let us find the limit of the function at x equal to 1. Limit x tends to 10, x tends to 1 at this point is 2 into 1 plus 3, that is 5. So the 5 is nothing but the value of function at 1. Both are 5. So f is continuous at x equal to 1. Examine for fx equal to x square. This is continuous at x equal to 0. Okay, first of all, it has to be defined. If you place 0, then the function does not become infinite or indeterminate. So it is defined at x equal to 0, and the value is 0. Let us find the limit. The limit is x tends to 0 fx. Let us place the limit, that is 0 square, that is 0. So the value at x equal to 0 and the limit at x equal to 0, they both are same. So the function is continuous at x equal to 0. Fx equal to mod x at x equal to 0. So mod x is, if x is less than 0, it will be minus x. If x is greater than 0, it will be x. That is the modulus. So by definition, fx equal to minus x if x is less than 0, it is x if x is greater than or equal to 0. Let us apply. First of all, if you place 0 here, the mod of 0 will always be 0, right? But if the left hand limit is taken and the right hand limit is taken, 0 minus, 0 minus means 0, means minus x. So you have to place 0 here. So minus 0 is 0 only. let us place 0 plus, that is plus 0. Plus 0, that is plus x, is 0 again. The limit is 0. The value at x equal to 0 is 0. Both are equal. So f is continuous at x equal to 0. Show that this function is not continuous at x equal to 0. Let us see. First of all, it is defined at x equal to 0. It is defined. It has a constant value, which is 1. At x equal to 0, it is 1. We have to check at x equal to 0. When x is not equal to 0, the function is nothing but a polynomial. It is a polynomial. And I'll tell you after this completion of this discussion. If we apply the limit, place 0 here, it will be 3. And see, the value at x equal to 0 is 1, but the value of at x equal to 0, when we apply the limit, is 3. So the value of x equal to 0 does not coincide with the limit at f0. That is why this function is not continuous at x equal to 0. So please understand, all polynomial functions, they are continuous. So only this x equal to 0 is the point of discontinuity in this particular example. Next is, check the points where the cos function fx is equal to k is continuous. Check the points. The function is defined for all real number because the value will be k in any way. Let c be any real number. Let us apply the limit x to c. When we apply x to c, then also it will not change. It will be always k because fx is k. You put any value of x, it will give you k. So the value is k of the function and the limit is also k. Both are equal. Then the function is continuous at every real number. Prove that the identity function on real numbers given by fx equal to x is continuous at every real number. See, if you place c here, any real number, you get c. This is identity function. When you apply limit, that is x tends to c, if you apply x tends to c, that is x, fx is x, this will be c. In both the case, these are c. So this function is continuous at every real number, right? Now let us have some extension to our definition. What does it say? A real function f is said to be continuous if it is continuous at every point in the domain of f. So the domain has to be there. Sine function is defined or is continuous. Well, it is continuous actually, but for a certain domain it is defined. Various functions which are not continuous, but for a certain range they may be continuous. For certain domain they may be continuous. So this we elaborate what we have just said. Suppose we have f as a function which is defined in a closed interval. Means closed interval means a and b are inclusive. So it may be say 7 to 15. This may be a range. Here f is continuous. So if it is continuous at f, it needs to be continuous at every point in a and b, that is 7, 8, 9, 9.1, 9.3, 11.6. At every point between 7 to 15, the function has to be continuous between a and b and including a and b. So continuity of f at a means, when you apply the limit a plus, what is ab? The left hand limit is a plus. The right hand will be this will be b minus, because in this range a plus will be the limit and b minus will be the limit. So when you apply a plus, because this is the range, it will give you fa. You put a here. If you apply b, you get fb. You just observe that this extends to a plus and extends to b plus fx. It does not make sense. So if this doesn't make any sense actually. Because of this definition, f is defined only at one point. It is continuous there. That is, if the domain of f is singleton, means if you have a singleton, f is a continuous function. If the function defined as fx equal to mod x, is it continuous function? See, x means if x is less than 0, it will be minus x. If x is greater than 0, it will be plus x. So let us rewrite in a function form. Fx equal to minus x, if x is less than 0, that is in the number line, this portion, it will be minus x. This portion, it will be x, if x is greater than or equal to 0. And we know that f is actually continuous at x equal to 0. You have just seen in the example. Let c be any real number, such that c is less than 0. Let us assume one more c, which is greater than 0. In both cases, what happens? Then fc is nothing but minus c. So when you apply a limit x tends to c, it will be minus x. That is minus c. How about applying for c greater than 0? The fc will be c if you take this function. If you apply c here, it will be minus c. If you apply c here, it will be plus c in the case of x greater than or equal to 0. So we have taken the value greater than 0. So fc will be c, not minus c, because we are talking about this part of the number line. So x tends to c, if you place c, it will be c, unlike the case here. So we see that since the function fx, the x to c is equal to fc, that is, you are getting c, and at x equal to 0, you are again getting the equal number. So it is not valid for negative numbers. Not correct means it is not defined here. So f is only continuous for positive real numbers, for this number, because if you apply x as c, you get c, and when you apply x to any function, this function, it will be, if it is greater than 0, then it will be c. Both the cases, c will be equal to c, but here there is a problem. So we say it will be only valid for positive real number. So f is continuous at these points. If f is continuous at all positive real numbers. Discuss the continuity of this function. This is a polynomial function. So f is clearly defined, right, for every real number. Say we take c. So if you place c here, it will be c cube plus c square minus 1. So we know that this, if you apply x tends to c, this will be c cube plus c square minus 1. So limit also says it will be this. If you apply c directly to fx, apply c, you get this. These two are exactly equal. So the limit x tends to c for fx is fc. So f is continuous at every real number. So now f is continuous function. In fact, every polynomial is a continuous function. Discuss the continuity of the function this. Fx equal to 1 by x. S should not be equal to 0. So if you apply c here, it will be c, 1 by c. When you apply the limit, it will be 1 by x, that is 1 by c. So the value of the function at c, the value of function at the limit of the function at c is 1 by c. So c, at every point, you get the f as continuous, 1 by c. But c should not be equal to 0. So this is not defined for c or x. This is only defined for values which are not zeros. You cannot have a 0. But for others, f is continuous function. So let us define the infinity. What is the infinity? So analyze 1 by x. If you place x equal to 0, it will be, because anything divided by 0, it cannot be defined. It is indeterminate. So just to follow this discussion, that is going close to 0, let us apply some certain values. So if we have a function x, this fx, if this is 1 by x, if you apply x as 1, you get 1. If you apply 0.3, you get 3. If you apply x as this one, you get this. If you apply x as 10 to the power minus n, you get a very high value for 1 by x. Now, Let us do it for the negative values also. See, if we apply the value which is actually we have got value which is closer to an infinitely large value. When we took it to 0, this is very close to 0. Now let us see one more. Since we can give the value as this one, it will be this one. If you apply minus 1, you get minus 1. So what is happening here is, the value of fx may be made larger than any given number by choosing any positive real number very close to 0. So if it is x2 tends to 0 plus, it will be plus infinity. This is infinity. So the right hand limit of fx at 0 is plus infinity. And the left hand limit of f at 0 can also be found, because this is the right, we have seen the right hand limit. This is approaching plus infinity. But see, this is very huge number, very huge number for value which is going to 0, near to 0. Again, when we are applying the negative high value, it is going to negative highest value. The left hand limit is also showing that for 1 by x, we have just seen that when we are approaching 0, that is the minus of this, you get again the same stuff. If you actually see the function, if this is 0 minus, it tends to minus infinity. If it is x tends to 0 plus, it tends to plus infinity. As we have seen the values, we have put in the values, and we have to try what exactly values we get if we do 1 by 0, which is not 0, but left hand limit and right hand limit. So we are finding the value of 1 by 0 this way and that way, left hand limit and right hand limit. In both the case, if it is plus or negative, you see, it never touches this axis. It never touches this axis. Okay? So this is the reciprocal function which we have just seen. So we emphasize that minus infinity is not a real number. Plus infinity is not a real number. So f at zero, it does not exist. It does not exist. This is infinity. Discuss the continuity of function f defined by this. So the best way is to just draw a number line and see x is less than or equal to 1. If this is 1, all these values, it will be x plus 2. All here, it will take x minus 2. So the function f, first of all, it is defined at all points on real number line. Let us take cases by cases. If c is less than 1, if it is less than 1, it will be what? X plus 2, that is c plus 2. And the limit is what? You place c here, so it will be c plus 2. So for all numbers less than 1, f is continuous, because the value at c and the limit at c, they both are equal. Let us take one more case. C is greater than 1. So when we apply c, it will be c minus 2. When we apply the limit, it will be c minus 2. So for x greater than 1, it is continuous. It is continuous. See, here it is continuous. I don't have to lift the pen. Here also it is continuous. We don't have to lift the pen. But what at 1? What at this point? So we take this c equal to 1. The left hand limit, that is the 1 minus, will be what? It will be x plus 2. If you go to 1 minus, that is this point, you take x plus 2. If you take this point, it will be x minus 2. Here you put x equal to 1, that is the value of c should be placed. This is 1, we are checking at 1. It will be 3. When you place 1 here, it will be minus 1. The left hand limit and right hand limit, they are not equal. So at x equal to 1, it is not continuous. The function is not continuous at x equal to 1. So x equal to 1 is the only point of discontinuity in the function which is described by this relation. Okay, so it is not defined at x equal to 1. I must not say that not defined, but it is not continuous at x equal to 1. But apart from these value, apart from this value x equal to 1, it is purely continuous and defined. Okay, I hope you got the idea. Now let us find all the point of discontinuity of the function. So see, in the question only the answer lies, because they have given the values at 1. So let us take, if the point which is just, because this is 1, just here, this point, it will be this function, it will be this function, so we will take x plus 2, we will place 1 here, it will be 3. At this, just this point, what will be the function? We will take this function. So this will be x minus 2. So x minus 2, we place x equal to 1 in both the cases, it will be minus 1. Left hand limit, right hand limit, not equal at x equal to 1. So x equal to 1 is the only point of discontinuity of this function. Let us discuss the continuity of this function. So we have 0, all x less than 0 is x plus 2, all greater is minus x plus 2. So just observe, the function is defined for all real numbers except 0. The domain of the function will be, let us union it, d1 union d2. So d1 will be all real numbers, domain will be all real numbers, you can give any real number here. So x belongs to R for x less than 0, and for here x is less than, x belongs to R for all x greater than 0. Now apply case by case. Now C belongs to D1, that is the domain 1. So we apply x plus 2. This will be C plus 2, which is equal to FC. So it is continuous at D1. It is continuous here. Then we apply the D2. X tends to C. So we'll take the second function, minus x plus 2. Again we apply this, we put C here. It will be minus C plus 2. So F is continuous in D2. D1 and D2, they are both continuous. So now we say that f is continuous at all points in the domain of f. In the domain of f. So we are getting what? We are getting that f is actually continuous. How? If I draw this, I don't have to lift the pen. And we have proven also. Because if you take the domain of these two, in both the domains, here and here, they both are defined. F is continuous at D1, F is continuous at D2. So on the all or in the domain, in the complete domain, it is defined. And what we said, that from A to B, if A to B, it is defined at all points, or it is continuous at all point, we said this function is continuous. If you have any doubt, just see your pen. If it is not lifted, it is continued. It is continuous. Okay. So we don't have to lift the pen. This is very important. Discuss the continuity of this function. X, if x is greater than or equal to 0, and x square if x is less than 0. This is the function. So let us take the domain. What is the domain 1? For all x less than 0, d2. 0, d3 greater than 0. That means now we have to check with domain wise. We see we need to partition it. Always it is not the case that you find the function continuous everywhere. For that we need to define it into different domains, as we just saw in the previous example. These are the disjoint sets. Let us take the first case. At point D1, we have fx equal to x square. So, because this is already we have seen, x square was continuous. Fx equal to x for D3. As we have seen in the previous example, fx equal to x is also continuous. So, what we say, we check for case 3. X equal to 0. We put 0 here. We put 0 minus and 0 plus. X square and x. We get 0 in both the cases. So, the value at 0, that is C, the limit at C, they both are equal. So when it is continuous and D1, D2 and D3, we say that it is continuous at every point in the domain. So f is continuous function. Show that every polynomial function is continuous. What is polynomial function? It is given by a0 plus a1x plus an x to the power n. This is a polynomial function. See, this should not be equal to 0. So it is defined for every real number. This we know. Let us take any fixed C. So it will be some PC. And by definition, we know that P is continuous at C. P is continuous at C. Since C is any real number, P is continuous at every real number. That is why P is continuous function. I am just saying, in this question, polynomial means we have already seen that. Just recall that function P is a polynomial function, which is this for some any natural number, this one, n. So for every real number, it is defined. If you take any fixed C, you will get some value, and that will be equal to x to C. If you place C here, say I am taking a0 plus a1x. If I place C here, it will be a0 plus a1x. If I apply the limit, it will be a0 plus a1x, because it is not defined for various domains. Again, this will be a0 plus a1c. This will be a0 plus a1c. So the value at C and the value at the limit at C, they are equal. If I just add a2x square plus a2x square, again this will be polynomial. So again c square, these two are equal. So if I extend it also, it will be polynomial function and it is continuous. Find all the points of discontinuity of the greatest integer function defined by fx equal to x, where x denotes the greatest integer function less than or equal to x. So if you take 3.2, the result will be 3. Greatest integer function is like this. We have to take an integer number which is less than or equal to this x. So first, f is defined for all real number. The graph is like this. See, at every point, if I give 3.2, it will be 3. If I give 3.8, it will be 3. If I give 3.9, it will be 3. If I give 3.1, it will be 3. All these values, different values gives me 3. The same case is here. We have, for all this range, the value will be this. For all this range, this will be this. All range, this will be this. This is, I have to lift pan every time if I want to draw it. So let us take case 1. If C is real number which is not equal to any integer, you see that the graph, that all the real numbers close to C, the value of function is equal to C only. That is, the limit also will give you this C. FC is C, limit is C, so the function is continuous at all real numbers not equal to integers. And if F's this C is, say, an integer, here we have taken it is not an integer, here we are taking it is an integer, that is 2.3. it is not an integer, 2 is an integer. So we just find very sufficiently small real number which is greater than 0, such that C minus R, we find any number which is very small real number, it should be greater than 0, that C minus R actually becomes C minus 1. And C plus R becomes C. Okay. So the limit, it means if you apply C minus, it will give you C minus 1. If you apply C plus, it will give you C. Since these limits cannot be equal to each other for any C, this function is discontinued at every integral point. So this first part we have seen about differentiability and continuity. We'll be taking few more. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.